What's up, Totally Inspired community? Welcome to another episode of Totally Inspired with me, your girl, Sibo Dube. Reverend Jesse and Mrs. Jacqueline Jackson are reported to be fighting COVID-19 in two different health facilities in the United States of America. Jonathan Jackson, one of their five children, revealed in a statement issued on Friday this week that his father's symptoms are abating. But before we get started, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. Trust me, you'll enjoy this content because it is here that you will be inspired to be more, do more, and focus on being a positive force in society. Now that you've subscribed, let's get right ahead. A family statement released on Friday, August 27, said Jacqueline Jackson had been transferred to an intensive care unit at Northwestern Memorial Hospital, while the Reverend has been moved to the Shirley Ryan Ability Lab in Chicago, which specializes in physical rehabilitation. Jonathan Jackson, one of the couple's five children, says in the statement that his father's symptoms are abating, according to a report by CBS News. Both our parents are continuing to receive excellent medical care, Jonathan Jackson said in the statement. We urge that you continue to keep them in your prayers because we know this is a serious disease. The Jacksons were admitted on Saturday, 21 August. Reverend Jesse Jackson has been vaccinated against the virus and has been an advocate for vaccination against COVID-19. Earlier in the week, Reverend Jackson told the Associated Press that his wife has not been vaccinated since she has a pre-existing condition that they were concerned about. Mrs. Jacqueline Jackson met her husband during her freshman year at A&T College. On December 31, 1962, at 18 years of age, Mrs. Jackson married Jesse Jackson. Together, they have five children: son Tita, born in 1963, Jesse Jr., born in 1965, Jonathan Luther, born in 1966, Youssef Du Bois, born in 1970, and Jacqueline Lavinia, born in 1975. During the United States presidential election of 2008, Mrs. Jackson supported Hillary Clinton as the nominee over Barack Obama. Discussing politics on NPR, she stated, "The image of women is at rock bottom. I'm looking for someone to elevate not only the economy, but the image of women." Her husband, Reverend Jackson's fame dates back to the 1980s when he achieved worldwide fame as a politician and as a spokesperson for civil rights issues. He has done extensive work in Africa, including being an active force in the campaign against apartheid in South Africa. Jackson first visited South Africa in 1979 following the death of Steve Biko. He attracted huge crowds at his rallies in Soweto, where he denounced South Africa's oppressive system of apartheid. In 1979, when he visited South Africa, he spoke out against apartheid. Upon his return to the United States, Jackson intensified efforts to mobilize a campaign against apartheid and reshape U.S. foreign policy concerning the regime. Wherever you are in the world, please do take a moment to pray for Jacqueline Jackson together with her husband, Reverend Jackson. There is power in prayer, and if ever there is a time we must pray for one another as the human race, it is now. Reverend and Mrs. Jackson, we are thinking of you. May your health be fully restored. Blessings to you. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for stopping by and watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share. Until next time, keep inspiring.